Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Tufail Sharif, welcome you all in the second edition of the Orange City Literature Festival, organized by SGR Knowledge Foundation. This session is of 40 minutes, and this is a panel discussion on topic crime fiction, an instigator or inhibitor. I'm pleased to welcome the speakers for this session, Mr. Abir Kapoor, Mr. Anuj Tiwari, and Madam Tanushree Poddar. I'll welcome them and I'll introduce them. Mr. Abir Kapoor, sir, is a journalist, board game designer, and an author. He is the creator of India's first election-based board game called The Poll, which has been featured in CNN, Vice, The Diplomat, and several other national and international publications. He is the author of the most notorious Jailbreakers, Rupa 2020, which has been just acquired by T-Series for digital rights. His articles has been appeared in Hard News, The Wire, The Scroll, Quartz, and others. He is currently building a new suite of games on digital citizenship and writing a graphic novel. We welcome you, sir. I also welcome Mr. Anuj Tiwari, a TEDx speaker and a marketing consultant settled in Mumbai. Anuj Tiwari was brought up on the bustling streets of Bareilly. Sir studied in Hindi Sanskrit medium school, where there was no English books. Seeing the kids of his neighborhood reading the colorful storybooks, he started building dreams of being able to read in English. However, he kept those dreams to himself. Despite going through 6 months and different problems, the sir has been one of the best-selling authors of five books and inspired by real-life incidents. He's also been listed as one of the top 10 most influential authors in India from 2016. We welcome you, sir. Ma'am, now I welcome Tanushree Poddar, ma'am. Ma'am was born at New Delhi. Ma'am worked in the corporate sector for 8 long years before she quit the rat race to start writing. A well-known traveler and writer, novelist, she's a passionate about traveling and writing. Climate change and environment are rare of the special interest to her. She has written 10 novels, and among her books are Nuja's Daughter, Boot Belts, Barrett's, On the Doubles, and many glorious works ma'am has already done. A Closet of Skeletons, Before You Breathe are some of the ma'am has been authored, and I must mention Boot Belts, Barrett's, and On the Double have also been acquired for the adaptation into web series. We welcome you, ma'am. I also introduce the moderator for this session, RJ Nisha. She's a radio jock and she has been awarded as the best jock of the city and a best female jock of Maharashtra by Big FM. But for her, the best award is when she gets a call or a message saying, "Hey Nisha, you bring a smile on my face every morning." And indeed, ma'am, you just did with us also. So with the same energy, I welcome you all and hand over the session over to you, Nisha ma'am.
Thank you, Tufail.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Tufail, for doing this again for me. And hey guys, good afternoon. It's been a great time knowing things into the Orange City Literature Festival. I would have loved to meet you all in person and been interacting, but nonetheless, we bring to the new virtual feeling and adaptability of saying that this is the new normal for us. Abir sir, aap bahut serious lag rahe hain. So chaliye sabse pehle aap hi se shuru karte hain hum ki हम जो क्राइम फिक्शन की बात करते हैं, इस जॉनर की बात करते हैं, तो वी बीन सीइंग दैट कि ये आज ही या कल ही में नहीं बना है, 70s 80s के दौर से हम इसे देखते आए. सो व्हाट डू यू एक्चुअली मीन बाय क्राइम फिक्शन, यू नो, एज अ पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ अ राइटर, एज अ पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ अ रीडर, आपके लिए क्राइम फिक्शन क्या है?
तो दिस इज रियली इंटरेस्टिंग. सो क्राइम फिक्शन डजंट एक्चुअली कम इन द 70s एंड 80s. Crime fiction, again, is a bane of the colonial period. The first set of penny thrillers that started coming up around the late 19th century found their way to India. So, pehli jo types of crime fiction started coming in were adaptations of Sherlock Holmes. So, Lahore mein jaakar Sherlock Holmes ban jate Shariq Hamid. And those they become readings, essential readings to get into the imperial civil service. So, agar aap police ka exam de rahe, to understand policing, you had to read Sherlock Holmes, and it starts getting transliterated into Urdu. And then the next sort of phase of writing takes place ki khatri samaj mein where the printing press starts picking up, you start seeing the rise of lots of detective fiction. Ek in Lahore, in Punjab, you're seeing Zalim Daku and the Rubber Sea Monster, and you are seeing Khoon Bari Katori, and you're seeing all of these sort of little detective stories coming up. But then Bengal picks it up and Bomkesh Bakshi becomes the first proper articulation of detective fiction in 1924-25. Now, the beauty about Bomkesh Bakshi is that crime fiction is rooted in reality. It is always looking at ways of telling real life. So, agar to pehli jo kitab thi Bomkesh Bakshi ki, Satya Ranveshi, had a cocaine mafia in it. Now, we're all thinking that cocaine is a new problem. But cocaine actually comes into India in the late 19th century, early 20th century, where the Indian medical journal is advising young women not to eat cocaine kyunki shaadi nahi hogi. So there is an international pura syndicate that Bomkesh then unravels and solves. So detective fiction has a long history in India. It has regional responses. It is also seen as the rise of a Bhadralok. So for me, detective fiction is a way to understand and tell a history of a time, a history of a place, a history of a people, a history of a region. Because if you look at the most sort of beautiful articulation of detective fiction, which is what England does, nowhere else better than England, you see the sleepy like landscapes, you see a interaction of the detective with the city, with the country, with the people. When you think about 19th century England, who do you think of? Sherlock Holmes. And that's how you enter that city. So there is a relationship between detective fiction, crime fiction, and the city, which they lie. So this is my opening remark.
तो अनुज सर, अगर आपसे जाने तो आप संस्कृत बहुत अच्छी बोलते हैं और हम भी संस्कृत की एक ही चीज याद है, पठती पठित पठंती, इसके आगे की हम हिंदी बोल रहे हैं. No, but coming back to you, like you always thought of being a writer, and आपने कभी उसको ज़्यादा उजागर नहीं होने दिया क्योंकि आपको कहीं ना कहीं डर था कि लोग उसका हंसी नहीं उड़ा दें, मजाक नहीं बना. And now you're one of the best sellers and influencers, I could say. तो अनुज सर, लेकिन अगर हम क्राइम फिक्शन की इस बात करते हैं, आपको लगता है कि आज भी लोग वो रेलवे स्टेशन पर जो किताबें मिलती है क्राइम फिक्शन वाली, वो इंटरेस्टिंग तरीके से आज भी लेते हाथ में पढ़ते हैं, या ई बुक्स पर आ गए हैं तो यू नो दैट चाओ दोस बुक्स आर मिसिंग नाउ?
सी, आई वुड लाइक टू आंसर कि मेरी जो कहानियां हैं वो कहीं ना कहीं जो है वो यू नो ट्रू इंसिडेंसेस और ट्रू स्टोरीज से इंस्पायर्ड है. तो मैं उतना कोर में जाने के बजाय मैं बोलूंगा कि मैंने जितना भी लिखा है अभी तक अपनी कहानियों में, ज्यादातर तो वो रोमांटिक रही है. कुछ कहानियां हैं जो रिसेंट अभी रिलीजेस थी, वो बेस्ड ऑन यू नो द क्राइम दैट वी फेस ऑन डेली बेसिस, राइट? सो लाइक माय लेटेस्ट बुक विच इज बेस्ड ऑन लाइक मैटर रेप, विच इज बेस्ड बाय लाइक माय सिस्टर्स लाइफ. So these are the crime I would talk about, which is based on, you know, daily basis that people face it. Now, going back to those stories that we used to buy in like 10 rupees, 20 rupees on railway station, I think the charm is still there. And I would, as a reader, I would go back and read those stories, because jo kahin na kahin jo naye zamane ki jo kahaniyan hain, wo kahin na kahin zarur jo unki jade hain, wo aaj bhi wahi hain. आज भी अगर रेलवे स्टेशन पर आप जाएंगे, अभी तो मैं लखनऊ में रहता हूँ, बरेली में भी मैं जानता हूँ कि एक बहुत छोटा सा बुक स्टोर है जो मुझे लगता है करीब 15-20 सालों से वो वहीं का वहीं है, और वहां पर आज भी जो है वो लेटेस्ट फिक्शन नहीं होते हैं, जो ब्रांडेड बुक्स है वो नहीं होती है. आज भी वहां पर वो जो 49 रुपीज, 99 रुपीज की जो स्टोरीज थी, छोटी पतली सी किताबें होती हैं, वो आज भी वहां बिकती है और लोग उनको पढ़ते हैं. तो मुझे लगता है कि वो जो चार्म है वो अभी भी वहीं पर है, और उसकी एक रीडरशिप भी है, और उसको हम कहीं ना कहीं भुला कभी भी उसको भुला नहीं सकते. वो उनकी जो हमारी जो आजकल की किताबों की जो जड़ें हैं, वो अगर आप सुरेंद्र मोहन पाठक जी का एग्जांपल ले लीजिए और बहुत से ऐसे जो राइटर्स हैं, उनकी जो किताबों की जड़ें हैं आज भी वही उन्हीं किताबों से जुड़ी हैं. तो मैं मानता हूँ कि किताबें चाहे वो 50 पेज की हो, वो 50 रुपए की हो, और वो आई गेस मुझे लगता है कि समय बदल जाएगा, लेकिन जो कहानियां हैं वो कभी नहीं बदल सकती. आप कहानियों की मैं बोलूंगा जो महत्ता है, जो इम्पोर्टेंस है, उसको पन्नों से या समय से मेजर नहीं कर सकते. तो मुझे लगता है कि वो बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है.
Absolutely, like he said. Tanushree ma'am, coming to you, you've been a traveler and aap jitna ghoomti hain utni cheezon ko likhti bhi hain, bayan bhi karti, and it's beautiful part of, you know, writing down all the stories. Lekin jab hum baat crime fictions ki karte hain, and you feel ki ise ek ye ek aisa genre hai ki jab hum padhte hain to you have that feeling ki ab kya hoga. It has that adrenaline rush inside you ki jahan dar bhi lagta hai, maza bhi aata hai, ending bhi janni chahiye. So, ये एक ऐसी चीज़ है which will always make you come back towards it. So, you feel, is it really true?
It is true because crime fiction is basically, you know, challenging the reader to pit the intelligence against that of the author. अगर आप crime पढ़ें and you are not able to, you know, go with the flow and you can't find out कि कहाँ पे क्या red herring है. So you'll, you know, keep continuing chapter after chapter because you want to know what is next. And those are known as cliffhangers. Jitne cliffhangers hai, the more interesting a book becomes. And like Abir said, yes, the contemporary life has always been reflected in a fiction, whichever fiction. And so too the crime fiction also. We always try to bring out social issues at some point of time in some manner or the other. For instance, my book, Closet Full of Skeletons, is actually a lot about Bollywood. So it's about a film star who retires into the hills. And she's writing her memoirs in which she actually is giving out the true story, how she was exploited. So there is mention of the couch, you know, casting couch and all that. And that's the reason she gets murdered, because all these men don't want the truth to come out. They have a lot to lose. So basically, you know, you deal with issues while creating a very mysterious book and, you know, crime thriller, which will, you know, interest the readers. So to that extent, I think, yes, we all try. And I have written in many genres. In military, then I have written in historical, and lately I have been writing crime because I have been fascinated by crime from the very early years. In fact, I'm a hardcore Agatha Christie fan, and like Abir said, that, you know, those the misty mountains and the, you know, atmosphere in which you set the mystery is very important. And that is the reason I have created a fictional city, a town rather, in the hills called Ramsar. And it's born out of my traveling experience. Actually, my husband is in the army. So we were posted at a place called Pithoragarh, which I don't know whether you've heard of it. It is in Uttarakhand. It is right on the foothills of Himalayas. And it doesn't get so much tourism, but it's a beautiful place when you talk about pine forest and misty mountains and, you know, low clouds and houses that are very quaint and beautiful. You know, get the picture. So all this really adds up to the mystery, the setting and the characters and the plot itself. So creating that kind of mystery and taking the story forward is a challenge, actually, which I quite enjoy.
Absolutely. Abhi, so coming back to you, jab hum detective stories ki baat karte hain, hum jo murder mysteries ki baat karte hain, to ek, you know, it's a psychological thing ki agar aap bahut zyada in cheezon ko padhe to aap har ek ko shak ki nigahon se dekhne lag jate hain ki samne wale mein zarur kuch gadbad hai. You know, you start becoming Ace Pradyuman inside you that kuch to gadbad hai yaad aaya. So you really feel ki ise thoda, you know, break de dena chahiye hame, ya ise aur padhte rehna chahiye aur shayad kahin aisa na ho jaye ki we start becoming and solving cases ourselves.
To I'm not sure ki dal mein agar kuch kala hai ya nahi hai, but main aapko zarur bata sakta hu ki detective fiction kuch aur karti hai dimag ko. Jaise Tanushree ne bola ki you are ek tarike se immersed in a world, par dusri cheez jo ho rahi hai ki जब तनुषी जी ने बोला क्लिफ हैंगर्स होते हैं, बट वॉट इज एब्सोल्युटली एसेंशियल कि आप ऑथर के साथ अपने विट्स टेस्ट कर रहे हैं, यू आर कॉन्स्टेंटली पजलिंग. तो डिटेक्टिव फिक्शन आपको क्रिटिकल थिंकिंग सिखाता है, आपको प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग सिखाता है, इट टेल्स यू. एंड व्हेन एक तरफ आप देख सकते हैं कि पूरी शक की तरफ आप लोगों से देख रहे हैं, और दूसरी चीज आप सीख सकते हैं कि हर दम बुरे के ऊपर अच्छाई अच्छाई की जीत होती है. गुड ऑलवेज ट्रायम्फ्स ओवर इविल इन डिटेक्टिव फिक्शन. द बैड गाइज ऑलवेज गो टू जेल. सो देयर इज अ हैवी मॉरल कंपोनेंट टू डिटेक्टिव फिक्शन. And which is also very interesting, even in something like, agar aap, if you go back into Indian detective fiction, Bomkesh Bakshi, jiske upar maine apni thesis bhi likhi, and in my book, The Most Notorious Jailbreakers, one sort of thing that we found that the bad guy always was in prison. Of course, they got out and then they were brought back in as well. But the detective, the police officer was a person who is carrying a certain type of thought. Wo ek tarike se problem solving, crime solving, law ke law carry karte the apne saath. A modern belief ki agar aap galat karoge, you will not be killed, you will be put in jail. So that was something absolutely revolutionary that detective fiction ne karna shuru kiya. Dusri baat, jaise if you read detective fiction, those people who read it, they have a very strong moral core. Ki they're able to figure out ki ye galat hai, murder is bad, it has to be punished. So ek bahut hi clear didactic purpose hota hai detective fiction ka. Maine galti se apni kitab mein I only focused on the culprits, but that is also very interesting kyunki detective ki ek duniya hoti hai aur apradh ki ek duniya hoti hai. And when you look at apradh ki duniya, you see what we call the marginal subaltern life of the criminal, the person who lives in the slums, the person who's not afraid to commit a crime, but what motivates them. So theory batati hai ki there is a variety of things, but coming back to your answer, one, yes, we can look at people with suspicion, but detective fiction, crime fiction, and the role of the detective always teaches us ki there is always good that triumphs over evil, and two, that it teaches us to critically think, that you are testing your wits with the author, and then that also pushes you because puzzling becomes a very, very interesting part of it. So it pushes the author, pushes the reader.
Absolutely. Sir, जैसे कि हमने कई ऐसे किताबें जब पढ़ते हैं तो हमें लगता है कि बहुत सारी स्टोरीज जो है वो रियल लाइफ से ही इंस्पायर्ड है. लाइक समथिंग इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द विंडोज ऑफ द मालदीव्स एंड ऑल दैट, या अगर आप सेक्रेड गेम्स की बात करें तो पीपल वॉन्ट्स टू नो वॉट इज इनसाइड दैट. बट कहीं ना कहीं हमें लगता है कि जिन चीजों की दिमाग पे जो असर है, वो चीजें एक ऐसे दौर में चले गए हैं हम कि जहां हमें लगता है कि वी कैन डू दिस, इट इज नॉट इम्पॉसिबल फॉर अस टू डू इट, अचीव दिस. एंड एट द एंड ऑफ द डे देयर सम स्मार्ट पीपल हु विल से दैट, चलो ठीक है यार, ये एक फिक्शन था, इसे भूल जाते हैं. कुछ लोग होते हैं इसे जो कैरी फॉरवर्ड कर लेते हैं. सो हाउ इम्पोर्टेंट इट इज फॉर द पर्सन टू राइट सच बुक्स कि आप अपनी मॉरल वैल्यूज को उसमें डालते रहें, इंट्रोड्यूस कराते रहें कि लोगों को.
The end of the story, the conclusion should be very positive. Positive, it doesn't mean that you have to kill the bad people or you have to save the good people, but at least anyhow, if you are ending the story, at least you should end on a positive note, so that it encourages people and readers to follow the humanity, we call it, right? So it's very important. And on the other side, people who are writing, people who are making like web series or movies or, writing books, so it's their responsibility how they're showing on the screen, how they're showing on the in the book. And it's a huge, huge responsibility because it's the first step that you are reducing it, right? It's coming on the screen at the later stage. You cannot say that I made something bad and now it's your responsibility to look at the right side. No, you cannot do that. So it's our responsibility. It's the very root of whole picture, that how you show it. And you have to keep the moral values in it. And you have to, there's no choice for that, right? If you're a writer, if you're a director, or you're a producer, you have to look into this. So that something is coming out of it and people watch it or read it, they should not follow it in a wrong way. So that's how I feel. Yeah.
So coming to you, Tanushree ma'am, when you talk about the crime fictions, we've been seeing about that, not though by reading, but by watching certain things with the crime fictions which were made on the reality basis, people really got inspired to commit certain crimes. You know, that ki acha ye aise bhi kiya ja sakta tha, ye humne socha nahi tha. Is cheez ko roka kya ja sakta? Because we're already living into the world where you find so much of negative characters around you that you really want to be at peace and all. So in cheezon ko na kiya jaye ya aap instigate na kare, aap kise kaise rok sakenge?
See, a writer cannot stop. वो जो criminal tendencies होती हैं in a human being, एक black side of a character, that cannot be controlled by a writer. In fact, even the society is not able to control it, because उसका character में that is overwhelming. The good side is less. It's like Jacqueline Hyde. So balance जब बिगड़ जाता है, तो writer कुछ नहीं कर सकता. He needs psychological treatment, psychiatric treatment, or some other form of, you know, reformation. But yes, like the others have pointed out, a big social responsibility is on the writer to bring out in subtle manner ki bhai ye cheez aapki galat hai aur isse wo bolte hai na kanoon ke lambe haath. So kanoon will so it's a very famous dialogue of Bollywood mein bahut use hota hai. कानून के लंबे हाथ, no one escapes the police. So basically, when you sort of bring that out, somewhere there is a little fear. Fear ही है जो इंसान को रोक सकती है. More than और कुछ, I think it's a fear. Fear of being caught, fear of being hanged, fear of being ostracized by the society, or fear of being punished. वही, you know, that delays his thinking process. Thoda sochta hai insaan ki bhai if I do like this what will happen. So the immature kind of reader will always be there. The yes, there have been umpteen instances jab bank robberies hui and they have said, oh, we read James Hadley Chase and we have got the idea from there. Now, but the thing is ki writer does not go about writing that book with that purpose in mind. उसने तो अपना काम किया है एंड ही हैज लेफ्ट इट फॉर द रीडर्स कॉन्शियस टू यू नो डिटरमिन क्या गलत है क्या सही है. सो लाइक आई सेड द क्रिमिनल साइड ऑफ अ पर्सन द लेटेंट टेंडेंसीज वो आप नहीं कुछ कर सकते हो. इसीलिए यू फाइंड इवन द टीनेजर्स नाउडेज कमिटिंग क्राइम्स विच आर यू नो अनइमेजिनेबल. लाइक इन द निर्भया केस द वर्स्ट वन वॉज द माइनर, which even I doubt whether he was a minor actually. So you know, the crime and punishment has to go in tandem. It has to be deterrent. And usme writer se jyada the responsibility rests on the law enforcers. Ki kitna aap law enforcement kar sakte ho, kitna aap social reforms kar sakte ho in the person who has these, you know, the dark side in his personality. So I do take care that hamara means as a writer I'm very aware of our social responsibility, but I really don't think that beyond a certain point a writer can do anything about it.
Abhi sir aapne jaise kaha ki aap jo apni kitabein jo likhte hain ya aap jo crime type karte hain to aap bahut deeply un cheezon mein jaake dekhte hain and you really feel ki jo insaan galat hai pakda to jane wala hai. तो आप जब कहानियों को लिखते हैं या जब आपके दिमाग में क्राइम रिलेटेड कोई स्टोरी आती है, व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट थिंग व्हिच कैचेस योर माइंड एंड व्हाट हाउ डू यू लव टू प्रेजेंट इट? लाइक इज देयर एनी स्पेसिफिक रीजन ऑफ योर्स जो आपको लगता है कि ये मेरा फेवरेट है, मैं इसके बारे में लिखूंगा, इसके बारे में लोगों को बताऊंगा और लोगों को जानना चाहिए इसके बारे में? सो व्हाट इज दैट रिगार्डिंग टू यू?
सो बिफोर आई आंसर दिस आई जस्ट वांट टू बिल्ड अप ऑन व्हाट your question to Tanushree was about criminality. Iske upar ek jo cheez hai ki as a writer, and I think I can dovetail this into my answer as well, ki abhi jo maine kitab likhi hai, which is the most notorious Jailbreakers, uske andar I have had to deal with the anti-hero. I have written 16 profiles of criminals. To 16 criminals ki maine unka pura itihas likha hai, unka pura setting likha hai, and you realize that different a criminal is made out of history, a criminal is made out of desperation, a criminal is made out of perhaps the dark side in them, which is the lust to kill or lust to rape. But all criminals aren't the same, and all criminals have to be written and treated and written about differently. which is the most exciting thing when writing about crime. एक तरीका हो गया कि I am wholly obsessed with cities, कि शहरों की कहानी आप इतिहास में लिखिए through a specific crime. तो मैंने एक स्टोरी लिखी थी लखनऊ के ऊपर जहाँ अनुज तिवारी जी हैं. It was an article that I wrote. वो हमारा भी शहर है, हमारे ताऊजी वहाँ रहते, हमारे दादा का शहर है वो. Which was the love story between a young talukdari woman who fell in love with a doctor in Balrampur hospital, and something goes wrong and she shoots him, or allegedly shoots him. So through that one crime of passion, you're able to tell a very different type of story of the city. Agar that was a premeditated crime, that crime would have a very different story. If it was a crime that pleaded insanity, that would be a very different crime. So one way of approaching crime writing is to understand what sort of crime you are writing about. Whether it's dacoity, if you're writing about dacoity, you have to go back to the 60s and 70s, or you have to go back to the 40s or the 80s, and then you have to write about Chambal, you have to write about the valleys and the ravines. So the type of crime starts determining what you do. Agar the graphic novel that we are working on is set in colonial India about a young man who is trying to prevent robberies, and then you are navigating something completely different. So the crime determines what you write, the city determines what you write, the time period determines what you write, and most definitely your character and how you and what you pour into them. Ye aap unko kaise dekhte ho start determining what you write. तो जैसे इन 16 स्टोरीज में हर जो जैसे नटवरलाल की कहानी बिल्कुल अलग थी जैसे सुकुर नारायण बाखिया की, एंड बोथ ऑफ देम विल रिक्वायर अ डिफरेंट स्टाइल, अ डिफरेंट फ्लेयर, अ डिफरेंट सेटिंग. सुकुर नारायण बाखिया सेट ऑन द पोर्ट इन दमन इन दीव, बोट्स आती उनके मिलने, ही कैन जेट सेट इन टू गोवा. या नटवरलाल जो कपड़े बदल देते, आग जला देते, पैसे को गायब हो जाते, कोई उनको जानता नहीं है. तो हर किस्म का क्रिमिनल, हर किस्म का क्राइम, हर किस्म की चीज रिक्वायर्स अ डिफरेंट ट्रीटमेंट, एंड दैट आई थिंक इज द ब्यूटी एंड आई थिंक द चैलेंज एंड द स्ट्रगल दैट वी फेस एज राइटर्स.
Interesting to do that. Anand sir, coming to you, you talk about the crime fiction, what would you like to, you know, suggest to the people who are wanting to write into this field? Ki kya aisi cheeze jinki pehle unhe taiyari kar leni chahiye, fir likh lena chahiye?
आई थिंक आप जिंदगी जियो, हमारे आसपास इतने क्राइम हो रहे हैं, सो आपको ऐसा कुछ पढ़ने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. और मुझे लगता है इतनी कुछ रिसर्च की भी ज़रूरत नहीं है, बिकॉज आप सुबह से उठने के बाद शाम तक जब आप अपने बेड पर वापस जाते हैं, आप जिंदगी में बहुत सारे क्राइम देख चुके होते हैं. और हमारे जो न्यूज़ चैनल्स पर आजकल जो चलता रहता है उसको तो देखते हुए तो आपको लगता है कि अगर मैं एक दिन में देख लूँ तो मैं शायद 5 किताबें तो वैसे ही लिख सकता हूँ.
पर जो न्यूज़ चैनल पर चल रहा है वही एक क्राइम है बॉस, जैसी न्यूज खबर चल रही है वही है क्राइम.
बट आई थिंक जैसे मेरी कहानियां जो है वो यू नो रियल लाइफ पे बेस्ड हैं, सो आसपास आप बहुत सी ऐसी कहानियां, मैं ऐसे शहर से आता हूँ, मैं बरेली से आता हूँ, मैं बॉम्बे में रहा और आजकल मैं तो अपने आसपास आप इतने लोग, जितना आपका सोशल सर्कल होता है उतना आप लोगों से कहानियां सुनते हैं, आप बहुत सारी स्टोरी सुनते हैं, चाहे वो बड़े शहरों की हो या फिर छोटे शहरों से आई हो. तो मुझे लगता है कि आप बस सुनते जाइए चीजों को, आप अपनी आंखें खुली रखिए, अपने कान खुले रखिए, और आप में अगर एक राइटर है तो इट्स वेरी इजी टू मेक द स्टोरी ऑल ऑफ इट. या बिकॉज़ जस्ट टू ऐड वन पॉइंट, बिकॉज जहां से मैं आता हूँ, जहां से मेरी परवरिश हुई है, आई डिड माई स्कूलिंग एंड देन स्टार्टेड राइटिंग. सो इन माई केस देर वॉज नो बैकअप, देर वॉज नो बैक सपोर्ट. Right, so whatever I learned, I made out of it. So mujhe lagta hai, if you are a writer, if you want to write, then it's not a very difficult job to start with. Though of course there are things, there are critical things, there are mechanism at the later stages. But I think initially, if you want to write, just go ahead and write it.
Cool. So the last question for the today, Tanushree ma'am, I would come back to you, and is that what do you really feel now? Is crime fiction a thing which is instigative for all of us, or is it an inhibitive for all of us? That
see, like I mentioned, instigator to nahi ho sakta crime fiction, There have to be a number of reasons. There have to be multiple reasons for someone to take up crime. Khali ek kitab padke wo crime nahi commit karta hai. Even if he's the hardcore, you know, detective crime fiction ka fan, mujhe nahi lagta hai. In fact, he would be more wary of committing a crime. So, instigator as such, I wouldn't say, but yes, agar dekho to newspaper can also be an instigator, like Anu said. एक बार न्यूज़पेपर या न्यूज चैनल देख लो तो उसमें भी आइडिया लग सकता है. द वन हु वांट्स टू कमिट अ क्राइम विल कमिट अ क्राइम नो मैटर व्हाट. द आइडिया कैन कम फ्रॉम एनीवेयर. न्यूज़पेपर से आ सकता है, अराउंड हिमसेल्फ व्हाट ही ऑब्जर्व्स या व्हाट ही रीड्स. एंड मेनी ऑफ दीज फेलोज हु कमिट वेरी बिग क्राइम्स आर नॉट इवन रीडर्स. वो शायद पढ़ते भी नहीं होंगे. सो यू नेवर नो व्हाट एक्चुअली इज क्रिएटिंग देम, यू नो, मेकिंग देम क्रिएट द क्राइम. So I don't think in strictest sense ki book padh ke koi crime commit karta hai.
Add on what Tanvi said. So in this book that I've written, The Most Notorious Jail, because you also find different motivations of the criminal. Ek jo story humne likhi hai, jo baad mein likhunga, is the story of a boy called Sajal Barwi. Who in 1992 was very, very upset with his father for marrying another woman. The motivation for his crime actually came from the news. कि वो BBC देख रहा था और किसी like वहाँ कहीं और murder देखा and फिर ये हो गया. या जैसे एक है in this book you see एक बुरेल jailbreak होता है जिसके अंदर these guys take over the prison through religion and then through religion they escape. तो and what got them there in the first place is religion. तो when you look at it being as an instigator and inhibitor, I think the and as these both Anuj and Tanushri have said, that our society in itself is enough of an instigator and enough of a catalyst to create crime. But again, I would like to say that it is also how we define crime. In colonial India, a dacoit who used to steal in the presidency states was a criminal, but used to come back to sort of nationalist kingdom and he was celebrated as a hero. So Robin Hood-esque nature of crime is also very, very interesting.
True. So on that beautiful note, we really will actually like to say this, ki bhaiya dekho, kitabe likhne wale sirf kitabe likhte hain, baki aapki soch par chhod dete hain. Jaise aapki soch, waise aap use paalenge. So thank you so much guys for joining with us. It was a wonderful session and I really wish ki jis tarike se Orange City Literature Festival aap jaise unda logo ko hamare saath jod raha hai aur logo ko apni messages pahuncha raha hai. We will have a wonderful time reading your books. And Abhir sir, Anuj sir, Tanushri ma'am, thank you so much for giving us a very beautiful books to read upon. And which really has a moral telling us ki hume galat kaam nahi karna, bas usse padhkar enjoy kar lena hai.
All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen and the viewers, and also obviously our speakers for today. We had a lot of things to take back with us. Also, thank you, RJ Nisha ma'am, for moderating this session. I extend my gratitude to the publishers also, Speaking Tigers and Rupa Publications India. On behalf of Foreign City Literature Festival, we sincerely express our gratitude towards your acceptance for the session and knowledge shared with us. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Tufil, and thank you, Orange City LitFest, for giving us the opportunity. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, RJ Nisha. Thank you, Tanushri. Thank you, Tufil. Thank you, Orange City.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, guys.
Twenty years of existence. Two universities. 23 educational institutes. Offering 137 courses. Thy Sony Group of Institutions. A vision beyond.